Well, the grid, sadly, is weakening, and in less than a half an hour... Oh, no, it's over. Less than a half an hour. Nope. Less than a half... Stop it. In less than 30 minutes, the remainder of my... I have, like, 50 batteries. Wow. 50 batteries. And they are depleting so fast now. It's just... I can't keep up with this. So... I've been chasing after this max consumption figure here for so long. This line here. I've been chasing after that for so long, and I've been running capacity that was enough to kind of run stuff that was running sometimes, but not all the time. And I had to do a whole lot of juggling of my power structure in order to make this whole thing work. I'm tired of that. I'm so tired of that. So I want to welcome you one and all to the latest episode of Satisfactory. And I want to welcome you to Power Station Delta. This is by far the refinery complex. Nothing on this. Any of the other power stations. Nothing on this. So when I flip... this switch right here, it's going to take a time for the system to prime itself. My hope is that, well, actually, see, once the system starts running, once we get some of the generators online here, this system's self-sustaining. So even if the rest of the grid shuts down before all the refineries come online, once this power station is running up to full and complete capacity, it won't matter. We just have to connect it to the main grid in order to get power into the crude oil pumps, so that way we can start extracting some crude oil to get these processes started. So, welcome to the channel, everybody. I'm so glad to have you here. Thank you so much for tuning in, and I do hope that you'll enjoy Power Station Delta. So now all that did... For now, all that did was just add more consumption into the grid as the crude oil system comes online. But now that this is online, we can kind of take a step back here and look at the absolute insanity that is Power Station Delta. There are two crude oil extractors in here extracting oil 600 cubic meters per minute. We have 20 refineries in the lower part of the complex here, all processing and turning that oil into heavy oil residue and polymer resin. So I had a few choices that I could go to get to heavy oil residue and make this work. I decided to go the heavy the polymer resin route, if I can actually steal one of these here. But you can see here, we can go with plastic, and we could have done plastic as well, but plastic doesn't do the same kinds of things. I actually can't leave that set to that for too long, or otherwise it's gonna start building plastic, and I don't wanna do that. Actually, wait, I can shut this off. Because I don't want to clog the system with plastic. But, you know, there's rubber. We could have gone rubber, and rubber would have produced 20 per minute. We could have gone with plastic. Plastic produces 10 per minute for 30, so plastic was definitely out. Heavy polymer resin, however, produces 20 per minute. It uses 60 crude oil per minute. Basically, the reason why I chose this is because we would have had to double the amount of refineries or overclock all of them in order to process all of this crude oil that we're pumping out of the ground. I didn't want to do that, so we went with polymer resin, and it's producing 130 of them per minute. So almost all of that polymer resin is getting dumped into this system upstairs here. I love I can fly around pretty much this whole thing with the hover pack. I have to have four, count them, four awesome sinks just to process the amount of overflow from the polymer resin that we're getting from all of those refineries downstairs. Because aside from this one refinery right here, which is taking some of the polymer resin, you can see it here, and it's producing plastic from it. And this plastic is being used over here to construct empty canisters, and those empty canisters in turn are used to package heavy oil residue whenever that starts pumping in through the pipes. You can see the pipes there are still empty. We're still waiting for the water pipes to get flushed and to kind of get pumped up here and start filling this guy as well. You can see there's no water up here. I have completely tested this facility, so I kind of took an old save and I, you know, just gave myself all the things I was going to need and made sure everything was running correctly. You can see the drone is coming in here to land. Pretend that it can fly in here and navigate this and not be ridiculous, but it's taking compacted coal from the platform out at the train platform. So all of that compacted coal that's being produced in that tower I showed you guys in the distance last time, that is what is feeding this entire system here. So once we finish up downstairs, and literally downstairs all it is it's just refineries. That's all that we've got down here. Essentially what's gonna eventually happen is these pipes are gonna completely fill up with heavy oil residue. All of it gets pumped into this central link, and there's another one over there, and then all of it merges into this single pipe that's carrying it all vertically up into this. And you can see that this is flushed full, so any moment now we're going to start getting some of that upstairs. I just love seeing this. You can see all the lights are on now, so we're definitely getting good oil distribution throughout here. All of our crude oil is coming all through the middle. That's where all of the oil is running through. And then the heavy oil residue and the polymer resin goes on the outside here. So let's head back upstairs. And you can also see this here. And this is one of the things I'm proudest of, is all these different things are just buried in here inside of these beam pillars. Everything I have over here is inside of these beam pillars. I think it looks amazing. We have four, count them, four hypertube connections, two of which will take you to the first floor, two of which will oh, this one takes you to the third floor. So this will take us up here. So we want to go back downstairs to the second floor. Two of these, actually, one of the ones that goes to the first floor and one of them goes to the second floor, even if this facility was offline, you could still use them. So I have them wired in specifically to still use the system even when they're coming through. You can see green lights are on up here, which means we have heavy oil residue pumping into this buffer, and now we are producing turbo fuel. We are producing 300 turbo fuel per minute. Now, the refinery complex that's up on top of the hill up there, for comparison's sake, is using, what, like 27 or something like that? No, it's not that much. There's three refineries up there, but it's using like 90 turbo fuel a minute, and it's splitting it over to the gas station portion of it up there as well. This is 300. That means we can run 30 fuel generators at maximum capacity. You can see we're getting water in here now, so we're producing our cans. All this stuff has been dialed in as well, so we're only producing exactly what we're going to need in plastics to create these empty canisters in here. All the rest of this stuff, all the polymer resin that gets backed up in here, then goes into a splitter, overflow into another one of these awesome things. I love. I really wish I hadn't put the drone port down here. I don't know why I did, but that was before I think I was going to build the fuel generators up top. So eventually, you can see this here, you can see turbo fuel is starting to fill into these pipes here. And eventually, what's going to happen is we're going to come upstairs and we're going to start to see this kind of thing. We're going to start to see these blue lights on. All of these have one of these guys in them so far. We can max overclock these with three, and it will use 9 turbo fuel. So the 30 generators I have up here, even with 30 generators, I still can't use all of the turbo fuel that this system is going to produce. And you can see it's getting dire straits. We've only got about 15 minutes before the system is completely overwhelmed, but you can see more and more of these generators are coming online. What this will do is it'll fill up all of these on the bottom floor here. Let's walk around so you guys can kind of get a sense of the scale of this thing. And I know you've got stuff like this, which is annoying, you know, that you can't really do much about any of that kind of thing. But, you know, we've got these ones over here on this side are just starting to come online now. I love this. You can see these pipes are flushing out here. And again, we have just whenever I could, I tried to use the verticality of these platforms and of these beams to take things up. And then we can use this. We can head up top here. We've got more of these up top, but these ones are unfortunately not going to get any fuel for a hot minute. It takes these ones a little bit of time before they can kind of get up and running. Look at that. Our consumption has jumped to 11,000, but we are almost there. We are almost there. Like, look at, we just about kissed it right there. So it's going to take some time. It takes time for the turbo fuel to really, really get pumped and primed. It has to prime the system. So basically, once it comes upstairs through two different pipe networks. It comes up over here and all the way over there in through the beam connectors, of course. Once it gets upstairs, the pipe network upstairs, it goes down through here. It comes over through here, down through this middle corridor here, which connects into all these fuel generators. I just saw you come online, buddy. And then it comes over here and it goes down underneath the glass and it comes straight across over here and leads into this one over here. So it's a closed loop. Once it gets up top, because it's got pumps pushing it up top, once it gets up here, then it is kind of swirling and flushing the whole system. But it does take time to prime these pipes and get them all full of turbo fuel. You can see, I don't even think there's any in that one yet. And up here, you know, same kind of thing happens. Once we get all these five backfilled, any overflow is going to go over here, spill over to this side, and then come over to this side. So again, closed system. Everything is going to get filled up once the pumps are primed. Pipes are primed, I should say. Once the pipes are filled, then this system is never going to shut down. Literally ever. Every single little bit of overflow that we possibly can have, every little bit of it is getting dumped into those awesome sinks downstairs. That's why, I mean, and I think these things are worth something like 12 points each, and we're producing something in the neighborhood of 2,600 of them that are just being dumped into the awesome sink every minute. So we're literally just basically printing points at this point. And, you know, I mean, I know they're not worth like the most amount of points, but, you know, it's just one of those things. It is what it is. This is the biggest linchpin in this. As long as the drone can keep up shipping in this compacted coal every time. But, I mean, basically these things only use what? Yeah, 30 compacted coal a minute, and we can ship in 250 per minute. We're not having an issue. We're definitely not going to have an issue with any of that. I mean, it's beautiful. It's just absolute and total perfection out here. And then we go up. And have we seen any of these top ones turn on yet? These are kind of the last ones. These are the last holdouts. Once these guys can come online, and you can see we are now officially producing more power. Oh, I love it. I love it so much. Well, once this entire thing reaches capacity, we should be producing, well, around this amount. It'll be pretty much even. It'll be pretty much even, but we're going to be dwarfing our current capacity, I'll tell you that. Because, yeah, current capacity is 11.5. But, yeah, we go way, way, way over that. So I'm going to hang out, and we're just going to stand here. And where's the power pole? We'll go right to this one right here, dead center in the middle of the room. There's power, the network of power that's kind of carrying through this whole thing. I love that I used the glass platforms for this so you can see through everything. I also love that I used this glass roof. But I kind of pitched it a little bit here and there. You guys can't really see it best until we get it. Oh, can I even get up here? No. You can see we just used little slants, little slanted 1 meter roofs, and then some flats. And some slants and some flats, and we kind of mixed it all the way across the top. See, look at we're going to pretend that he's just a smart drone and he navigates his way into the facility, you know, properly. Right? Right? No. But yeah, once all of these generators up top are turned on, we're going to reach maximum capacity for this facility. Now that looks a little bit more like what I was talking about. And now we can kind of take a little peek, see over here, in here, and bam. So we're up here right now at around 13.5, and you can see it's fluctuating up just a little bit more than that. Once we've got these things to their maximum, and I mean their maximum overclock, then we're going to be sitting way up around this number here. It totals out somewhere. Where is that? 13,745, 13,949. You know, so we're going to be right around 14,000, at least in the interim, while this power station continues to get primed and continues to kind of get up and running. We can see we're still struggling to get turbo fuel pumped up as fast as all of these things are using it. I think probably the ones over here, or maybe, yeah, the ones over here are still struggling just a little bit. Just a little bit to keep enough turbo fuel in the system, but eventually those pipes will get fully primed and we'll be ready to go. So the final thing we've got to do over here at Power Station Delta is, you'll notice I've been flying around this massive, and I mean this massive, massive battery bank right here. So there are 48 batteries here, and this is going to double the current storage capacity of my grid as well. So I've got these isolated. I did the same thing at Power Station Charlie, and I know I don't think I ever showed you guys that, but I did the same thing at Power Station Charlie, where my idea is, at least, you know, to kind of keep battery banks switched off, like fill them up, get them to capacity, and then switch them off so that way we're not relying on battery power all the time. And then if we run into a power situation where we know we need it, we can flip it back on. And there you can see we're starting to level off at the top there, 14,154. But that is way, and I mean way, above our current consumption. And that has not been like that in ages. Probably since back in the biomass burner days. This is how like much of a deficit I've constantly been running at. And I really wanted to build a power station that was going to kind of be the final solution until I hit nuclear. Because once I hit nuclear, it's pronounced nuclear. Once I get to nuclear power, then of course that's going to be like a huge injection into the grid. And we're not going to really need this kind of thing anymore. But I wanted to build something that I was not going to have to think about at all whatsoever. Power was not going to be an issue while I work on building things like the manufacturing plant or anything like that. So let's kick these online. It's going to take 4.5 hours to charge all of this, but we're going to be able to store over 10,000 megawatt hours once all is said and done. Power Station Delta. I know it's like, you know, there's no walls, and I didn't want walls. I wanted it to be open. I wanted to basically keep it wide, wide open like this. I got these jelly platforms at both sides. I died so many times out here building this thing, I can't even begin to tell you, because I had no power out here, basically. So it was just me with a jetpack and like creating ramps and doing other stuff. And even when I ran power out here and was using the hypertube, still didn't matter. Still didn't matter. We've got things like this guy here. I'm running this thing at 12.5%. I need so little water, but I gotta have something. I've gotta have it do something. So that's extracting water. Doesn't really, you know, it's just saving on power, basically, is the only reason I've got any of these things dialed back like that. Or, you know, it's because we only have 25 extra cubic meters of heavy oil residue being produced by the system. So I don't want to crank this up, because if I crank this to full speed, I mean, granted, it's at 85 almost, so it wouldn't use that much. I think it uses 30 on a normal clock. But, you know, then we'd be taking heavy oil residue away from the turbo fuel refineries, and we need it to produce turbo fuel. If we don't have it to produce turbo fuel, we can't run the generators and the system will inevitably shut down. I'm glad to see that this is going well. I don't know where that drone is, though, because once this is, like, you know, fully running, you know, I just kind of want to make sure he's not doing anything, or he's not too slow or anything. One thing that I noticed in my tests, which I haven't seen yet because we're still priming and filling the pipes up top, but one thing that eventually starts to happen, because, again, we're producing 300 turbo fuel per minute. Right now we're using somewhere between 180 and 200, because I think each one of these is using like 6 point something. Let me see. 6.15, yeah. So we're not even using 200 cubic meters of turbo fuel now. So eventually what's going to happen is the turbo fuel starts to back up down here, which is fine, because this is the only part of the system that can back up. As long as we have tons of turbo fuel, that's the only thing that matters. And the compacted coal, well, the drone will just sit there until it empties out enough to go take off and bring us another load of compacted coal. And we're producing 600 compacted coal per minute out at that tower out there. So we don't have any worries about running out of it. We even have more if we need to use it for something else somewhere else, because up top, the refinery project up there is only using 150 of it. So down here, we're using 300. We still have another 150 to spare. So I could build more turbo fuel refineries. And again, we're We've got more turbo fuel to spare up there in fuel cans. We could transport that somewhere else and then empty it out and then use it there. We could do so many different things. So we do even have some solutions in case power becomes an issue, but it's time to build the manufacturing plant. It's time to start pushing and getting these final tech tiers unlocked so that way we can get to nuclear power and, you know, get all that kind of stuff, get all that infrastructure and everything built. There's so much involved in all that stuff, though, so it's like, it's crazy. So I think what we have to do in the next episode, I don't want to do it. I don't want to do it, but we have 30 of these turbo fuel plants. I need 60 more of these power shards to fully overclock every single one of these refineries or of these generators. I have like 12 right now, I think. Just because, you know, they are used in other different places. Now, I did, in cleaning up my infrastructure in different places, I did recover a lot of them. So I have more than I had before I built all those little outposts and stuff and started using all the drones to fly stuff in. And once I kind of started recalibrating and kind of dialing everything in correctly, because I was doing a terrible job of it, absolutely, completely terrible. But, you know, now that everything is kind of up and running and doing the thing that it needs to be doing, everything is dialed in, everything is clocked correctly. Yeah, we just don't have enough of them. So we got to go power slug hunting. And I have picked clean pretty much the entire Dune Desert up here. All of this area, like this whole area, like all of this, I'm pretty sure it's pretty much empty of power slugs. So that means we have to press on into lands unknown to see if we can find some more. I'm not looking forward to it. We all saw what happened last time I ventured out when I was out building the aluminum train. So I'm scared. I'm so scared. I don't want to do it. I don't want to do it. But next episode is going to be me in the wilderness. And hopefully we'll find some drop pods too, so I can find some other alternate recipes and that kind of thing. And everything. See, there he goes flying straight through the terrain. Yeah, that'll be next episode. So if you want to see me be terrified of the spider creatures and hate the spitting things and those charging things and everything, then, you know, definitely make sure that you hit that like button so, you know, I get other people to see this stuff. Leave a comment down below. Let me know what you think of this massive... Oh, that looks beautiful with all the green lights in there now. I love that reflectability of the glass foundations and stuff. I love... One of my favorite things is just kind of being on the first floor of this thing and just walking around and just looking down and just seeing water. What? You saw nothing. See? Just water down there. I think there's power lines underneath on the bottom of that thing, and they are connected to like this thing. Yeah, I think it's something like that. See, the good thing is now too is though, like, even if we shut this off, even if we shut this switch off, all it's going to do is it's just going to disconnect power station Delta from the main grid. This power station will never shut down, ever. It will never shut down unless, I think the only thing that I could feasibly think of is if we run out of compacted coal, which I don't think we should have an issue with. That thing is bringing 9 stacks in every time it lands. So I don't think we are going to run into any kind of an issue. So yeah, that could be the only potential issue. What would happen if we just did... Yep. Oh, let's see. Now we're back to the scary times. I don't want to do that. We don't want to do that. We definitely don't want to do that. We want to make sure we stay connected to the grid at all times. But yeah, that's Power Station Delta, everybody. I really, really hope that you love it as much as I do. I'm absolutely loving this thing. I love that he makes this big ado of just he'll fly straight through terrain, but oh no, he has to go up above the drone platform, above any existing structure, to lower himself all the way down. I do wish I hadn't built it down there, but it's too late now. I am not redesigning this thing, and it's done, completely and totally done. So like I said, let me know what you guys think. Please make sure you subscribe to the channel so you don't miss out on my future Satisfactory stuff. And I will see you guys next time.